Jeff Bezos recently gave an interview in Turin, Italy, where he talked about building gigantic gigawatt data centers in space. He anticipates these facilities could be built within the next 10 to 20 years and be powered by the constant solar energy provided by the sun, unimpeded by clouds, rain, or the day-night cycle on Earth. But how realistic is it to build such large facilities in orbit? We'll look into what's possible with today's technology and what advancements in technology are needed to cut the costs and time required for constructing these vast structures in space. First, consider the advantages of locating data centers in space and why companies such as Blue Origin, Axiom Space, and StarCloud show keen interest in relocating processing, AI training, data storage, and more into orbit. After all, companies have already successfully shifted many technology areas to space. Satellites now routinely handle weather monitoring and Earth observation. Constellations like Starlink and others increasingly manage telecommunications, internet services, and mobile phone communications. Think about the advantages of putting internet services in space. Users can now access the internet from any location on Earth, a boat in the middle of the Atlantic, or a plane soaring through the skies. Astronauts even received Wi-Fi signals in space during the recent Polaris Dawn mission. Advantages of data centers in space. The cost of electricity and water has risen in areas hosting data centers. As these massive facilities demand vast amounts of power and water for cooling, due to their scale and energy requirements. Unsurprisingly, locals don't like their electricity price increases, making data centers unpopular. Unfortunately, due to AI training needs and the general growth of the internet, more and more data centers are needed. If construction continues solely on Earth, the necessary power generation could quadruple over the coming decade. Bezos said, "These giant training clusters, those will be better built in space, because we have solar power there 24/7. There are no clouds and no rain, no weather. We will be able to beat the cost of terrestrial data centers in space in the next couple of decades," unquote. AI is taking over so many industries, with every tech company seemingly building its own AI models. Each of these models demands an extremely large data center for training purposes. Not only that, but each new version of the AI model needs exponentially more power to train. Estimates suggest that next generation models under development may require up to 5 gigawatts of power for training alone. That's one model by one company. Now scale that up to all the tech companies working on AI, and you can see the problem. Before long, the required power will surpass what Earth's current infrastructure can provide. And, in the West at least, environmental restrictions, zoning and planning laws, and community resistance to AI data centers results in higher costs and longer timelines for construction. This risks Western tech companies lagging behind their competitors. Locating data centers in space gets around all these problems. No more problems with locals, environmental planning or zoning laws, and with 24/7 unlimited free power from the sun, there is no limit to the size of data centers, at least in theory. Security offers another advantage. No risk of spies infiltrating the facility to sabotage it or install backdoors. No exposure to environmental risks such as hurricanes, floods, tornadoes, or other kinds of environmental damage or disruption. On-orbit processing would minimize latency for satellites, such as those involved in Earth observation, military, or weather satellites. Currently, satellites transmit vast data sets to Earth for analysis. Why not process them in space, sending back to Earth only the relevant information? There are, however, a number of problems or challenges that will make it hard to locate data centers in space, at least for the next 5 to 10 years. Let's go over these issues now. Power generation. Orbiting data centers would depend on solar arrays for continuous energy supply. However, the largest existing system in space, the International Space Station, generates only about 240 kilowatts at peak. Scaling up to 1 gigawatt would demand solar arrays that cover millions of square meters, weighing thousands of tons, and operating in sun-synchronous orbits to stay out of Earth's shadow. Even with high-efficiency panels, the sheer mass and volume would require more than 150 heavy-lift missions using SpaceX's Starship at a cost of tens of billions of dollars for the solar components alone. With current launch expenses, or even those anticipated for the future Starship vehicle, powering a 1 gigawatt orbiting data center remains commercially unfeasible. One potential supplier of solar arrays is Redwire, which provides rollout solar arrays, or ROSA, for the International Space Station and the Axiom Space Station currently under construction. ROSA systems minimize launch volume, remain lightweight, and deliver high power output. They boast a 100% on-orbit success rate across various civil and commercial missions. To illustrate, consider how many ROSA units a 1 gigawatt orbiting data center would require. Among the available configurations, the Mega ROSA suits large platforms best. Each 400 kilowatt system consists of 2,500 solar panels and occupies 975 square meters when deployed. A 1 gigawatt facility would therefore need to launch and deploy over 2,500 systems, spanning a total area of 2.4 million square meters in space. This setup would use over 6 million solar panels. Radiation hardening. Electronic components in orbiting data centers would face far higher radiation levels, leading to data corruption, system reboots, or even worse, failures. Radiation hardened components would be needed, which costs 1,000 times more than standard components. Not only that, but radiation-hardened components lack substantially in capabilities compared to the latest technologies on Earth, making any system uncompetitive and so expensive as to become commercially unviable. No company would deploy an orbiting data center at vast expense unless it was competitive. Unfortunately, it cannot be made competitive while using radiation-hardened components. Hardening the latest CPUs and GPUs while not increasing the price substantially is essential before orbiting data centers become competitive. Or, a way for non-radiation hardened components must be found that doesn't introduce data corruption. One alternative involves magnetic shielding to deflect radiation, allowing unshielded electronics. Some of the enormous energy collected would need to be sacrificed for magnetic shielding. But the benefit is that the very latest components from NVIDIA could be used, making the data center competitive. Active magnetic shielding replicates Earth's magnetosphere through superconducting coils that produce fields to redirect high-energy protons and ions, the main causes of bit flips in space. Studies suggest that for a facility the size of a data center, magnetic field strengths of around 1 Tesla would be enough. Thermal management. Cooling. First, the good news. Thermal management in space proves simpler than on Earth, thanks to passive radiative cooling. This eliminates the need for energy-intensive air conditioning or water-based systems. In near-Earth orbit, temperatures range from about minus 120 degrees Celsius in direct sunlight to minus 270 degrees Celsius in Earth's shadow, allowing heat to dissipate naturally through radiation without requiring extensive active systems. Although electronics would still need active mechanisms to transfer heat to radiators, the overall demand falls far short of that in Earth-based data centers. Unfortunately, there is bad news that makes thermal management perhaps the greatest challenge for orbiting data centers. Radiators must reach enormous sizes to dissipate 1 gigawatt of thermal waste heat. Why? CPUs and GPUs operate at only 5 to 20% efficiency, converting the vast majority of harvest solar energy into waste heat. This heat requires ejection from the system, otherwise temperatures will gradually rise, triggering a thermal runaway effect that could melt the facility. In space, this heat can only be ejected by radiation, requiring large radiator surfaces. At a radiative cooling rate of 300 watts per square meter, 1 square kilometer of radiators becomes essential to cool the facility. For comparison, the largest radiators in space belong to the International Space Station and span 376 square meters. Cooling a 1 gigawatt orbital data center would require radiators over 14,000 times larger than the International Space Station's capacity, showing the immense scale of such a facility. Vulnerability to orbital debris. The sheer scale of a 1 gigawatt orbiting data center would expose it to significant risk from orbital debris. Featuring 6 million solar panels and over 1 square kilometer radiators, the facility would almost certainly suffer hits, leading to minor or potentially major damage based on the impact site. Over time, such incidents would degrade the efficiency of solar panels and radiators. The orbital debris problem continues to get worse, not better. Critical hits, such as the fluid cooling lines in a radiator, could damage the facility enough to cause a thermal runaway effect. This problem can only be fixed by clearing up all the circulating orbital debris, a huge task that will likely take decades to achieve. Launch logistics. Tens of thousands of tons of equipment would need to be launched, far beyond current annual global launch capacity. In-orbit construction is in early stages. Maintenance is equally difficult with robotic systems not sufficiently developed to enable assembling of such a vast structure in space. In the future, with heavy and super heavy launchers like New Glenn and Starship, it could make constructing massive orbiting structures commercially viable. Are 1 gigawatt data centers possible with today's technology? No is the short answer. Here's a longer answer. The core issue centers on cooling or heat dissipation. A 1 gigawatt orbiting data center would produce an enormous amount of waste heat, which must be removed to prevent the facility from melting. In space, with radiation the only means of cooling possible, giant radiators need to be attached to the facility. These radiators would span millions of square meters of space to have the necessary capacity to cool a 1 gigawatt data center. The mass of the radiators and solar panels needed for power generation would be thousands of tons. In addition, such large radiators would likely face impacts from orbital debris, reducing their effectiveness over time. Final thoughts. While 1 gigawatt orbiting data centers sounds like a cool idea, they cannot be assembled with today's technology. The cost of launching the necessary power generation and radiators makes a 1 gigawatt orbiting data center completely unviable from a commercial perspective. It's necessary to start with much smaller facilities and gradually expand them over time, potentially reaching 1 gigawatts in a few decades. What are your thoughts on assembling such enormous facilities in orbit? Should we be setting ambitious goals like Jeff Bezos, or should we be working towards much smaller sized facilities to begin with? Leave your thoughts and opinions in the comments section below. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this space video, consider buying me a coffee to help fund more episodes like this. The link is in the description. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. The live stream is a great way for you to share your thoughts and opinions on the videos I posted this week, or on any space topic in general. I highlight the most thought-provoking comments on videos I've received and previews of upcoming content. If you've got the time, please tune in and say hi. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.